an extremely brief background. In 2006, being the largest tax buyer in the country for a time, with many thousands of happy transactions over 17 years, where 99.9% of deals had no problem, I was in the middle of a wild business success, and where it seemed we were about to be jet rich, things got very complicated. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, did you ever wonder why the newspaper article and the DOJ press release describing me as the mastermind behind the vacant church lot stealing scam which destroyed me came to nothing? I was never indicted, arrested, or even questioned about the matter. Why? Because I was not involved in the way they initially assumed and reported. Ever wonder why, even though I was arrested 3 years later on a 16-count indictment having nothing to do with stealing church lots for mail fraud, bank fraud, and structuring, the government later dropped all charges against me except a single count of structuring, which is like dropping a murder charge for a guilty plea bargain for jaywalking? Why would they do that? Ever wonder why my private lawyer, to whom I signed over everything to represent me and to manage my portfolio and assets for the benefit of creditors and customers, was disqualified from representing me because the government claimed and the court agreed that he was conflicted and a target of the investigation, yet he was never questioned, arrested, or indicted? Ever wonder why I was then appointed a federal public defender who participated in a classic DOJ railroading who was later determined by the court to have been ineffective, resulting in an illegal sentence and denial of a direct appeal where I would have 100% certainly prevailed and set myself free? Just why did the Department of Justice drop all charges against me except a single count of structuring? Because it became obvious that I had a 17-year history of refunding many millions of dollars to customers whose tax certificates were deemed or went bad, and even though I borrowed many millions of dollars from the bank, I owe them not one penny. The federal sentencing guidelines for a single count of structuring with no companion crime, no illegal source of the funds, and no illegal use of the funds is 0 to 6 months in prison. In other words, probation. Instead, I received an illegal sentence of 9 years in prison, reduced to another unjust sentence of 5 years after a successful pro se appeal filed from prison. Ever wonder why, 1 year into my sentence, I won a pro se appeal filed from prison where both the government and the court instantly agreed that my sentence was illegal? Ever wonder why there was no DOJ press release or front page story about this outrageous catastrophe? Have you ever lost every single thing? Been chained at the hands, feet, and waist? Fed slop for years? Been stuck on a floor at MCC Chicago with 100 guys stacked 3 high for years? Been bussed all around the country while chained up or jetted all over the country on Con Air? Have you ever been canceled by all humanity? While I failed tragically in my personal life, I was and am extremely proud of my business accomplishments and tried to always operate an honest win-win-win business model. The county made money, my customers made money, I made money. It was perfect. Victim customers purchased tax liens from me and did not invest in me. And though extremely tragic, it is not illegal to owe money. Still, my own loss and suffering was always secondary to the loss and suffering of my victim customers, who, even though they gave me their hard-earned money, were made victim by the United States Department of Justice in their unjust destruction of me, making it impossible for me to repay my legitimate debts as I historically had. Why? Why did all of this happen? Because they had to get the church stealer, no matter what, even though I stole no property. And due to laziness, sloppiness, incompetence, ambition, and prejudice on behalf of the prosecutors, the probation department, the court, Judge James B. Zagel, and the federal public defenders, a complete total system failure. I assumed that when I got out of prison, I would set the world on fire, return to prosperity, repay my legitimate debts, and have the good life again. Instead, when I got out of prison, I was crippled with arthritis, seriously addicted to prescription pain medication, had a double hip replacement, realized that I was canceled, penniless, homeless, and was old, and I realized that no one would ever invest in a convicted felon. Perfect justice is impossible, rare, and expensive. I accept my destruction and cancellation for failing to consider a railroading by the feds in my calculus, and because of my many other legitimate failings. I forgive all and everyone for everything. Though I remain penniless, I only want to live free, pay my debts, and contribute to the world somehow. While this tale is far more complicated and nuanced than described here, it would be tempting for one to spin such a story to their advantage. But these are cold, clear facts. I seek only some greater understanding of these events and zero sympathy.